Hey, this is a Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to say a little bit in the defense of spaghetti code. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's right, I said it. Yeah, go. Alright, I just want to talk really briefly today about code quality, right? Here's a question for you. Which code runs faster? Well-formatted code or badly formatted code, right? It just, you know, you have some code that's really well formatted, really well documented, and you've got some code that's really badly written. It's very spaghetti code. It's all over the place, and it's not very well documented. Which one runs faster? Well, it's a trick question because it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, you know, which one is, how it's formatted or how it's documented. They could both run equally fast or equally slow. But if either one of them runs slow, which one is going to be easier to fix? Of course, it's going to be the well-formatted code. Right? We have a project at the moment where we've taken it over from like another company for our client. They had another developer do it, and we took it over for support. And it's one of these kind of things I don't really like to do. It's hard to take over a project that somebody else has coded. It's so much easier to do it from scratch. In fact, a lot of developers, that's the first thing they'll say. It's like, oh yeah, we got to rewrite it, right? Just because, you know, it just takes, you know, it takes longer to learn something that somebody else has done than it is to do it, right? So we got this project and we got a team. The team is, they're really good developers over, they're an Indian company that I've worked with for years, right? So they're working on it, and you know, they came to me today and say, thing is, it's not very well documented, and it's a bit complex, so it's going to take longer and all this kind of stuff. So but yeah, I was kind of expecting that, right? I've never seen anybody say, wow, this code is well documented, right? In all my 20 years in IT, I've never seen anybody compliment a code of somebody else they've taken over, right? It's always been like the cliche in software is like somebody comes over, takes over a project, and they just talk about the bad code of the previous person, right? Now, I know this isn't always the case. I know there've been organizations that have been more professional than all the ones I've ever worked in, right? But I just know, you know, from experience, you know, this is what it is. And I'm usually, you know, when I was a contractor, I hardly ever started anything new, right? I was always coming in and looking at other people's projects. So I got, you know, I actually got pretty good at just, you know, anticipating what they were doing, seeing a few bits of code and saying, okay, that's the level of thinking we're at, and we're gonna, you know, we'll go that way, and so we could troubleshoot based on that, right? Rather than just say, oh, this guy didn't know what he was doing, right? Because that's, it's just too easy to say that, right? So, you know, and I used to always say, you know, Facebook could be complete spaghetti code, but as an end user, I don't care, right? As an end user, it's fine with me. But, you know, I'm glad I don't have to maintain that code. Yeah, and this is the whole thing with code quality. And I know a lot of developers, we always like to complain about it. We talk about how important it is, and it is hugely important. But it's not important to the end user so much, right? And the problem with, this is my opinion, you guys could disagree with me. I know when I talk about this, it's like this, like a sacred cow thing, right? As a software developer, there's certain things we believe in. We believe in quality code, we believe in documentation, not so much documentation in terms of like a Word doc sitting on a shared drive someplace, but, you know, well-documented code, so it's clear and visible, right? You know, looking at industry standards for depending on the language, all that kind of stuff. But junior developers, when they come in, they usually don't care about that. They're, you know, and you, kinda, you know, if I told you about, you know, the first few software projects I worked on, you know, it's cringeworthy. I think every software developer out there, you know, they look back at their early work and think, ooh, that was, you know, God, that's kind of embarrassing. I hope nobody ever sees that, right? And anyone who doesn't think that about their early work, they're still coding that way now, so you want to stay away from them. In fact, one of the things that one of the things I try to stay away from when I'm hiring somebody is somebody who learned how to code and just coded on their own their entire career. If they're putting out their own stuff, that's fine because, you know, they know that. But if they've never worked in a team environment, then they're not as disciplined as somebody who, you know, they're not as disciplined as somebody who's worked in a team environment and had to not step on the toes of other coders, right? At the same time, somebody who's only worked in a team environment is also not a good fit because, you know, they might not be able to understand how other things, you know, work, and they've always had somebody else help them out or you know, with stuff, and they're not able to solve problems on their own. But yeah, anyway, it's just one of those things. But when you're learning how to code and you're reading the books and you're finally getting your Hello World example, like when you're first starting out, the two most boring topics are, you know, the code cleanliness and error handling, right? And, you know, because you just, you know, you're able to do stuff and you're able to code away and do everything. And it's hard to tell a junior developer to do these things. You have to, you know, stay on them and say, okay, look, you need to format this differently. You need to, you know, this is, you know, okay. And they said, yeah, but it's working. I said, yes, it's working, but it needs to be formatted differently. Look, you know, follow our guidelines. You know, variables need to be named this way. You know, this needs to be in a function. You know, this function is too big. You got too many, you got too many global variables being shared across, you know, all this kind of stuff. And they said, yeah, but it's working. I don't understand why you're saying, and they don't. It's really hard. You have to really, you know, get on there. And sometimes I just let it go. Like, it depends. If it's one of my own apps, I just, like, you think, okay, you know what, I'm more interested in this going live than I am in that, and we'll, you know, if it works out, we'll go for it, right? I know it's bad, but, you know, sometimes it's just easier. But, like, the first time a junior developer learns the importance of code clarity or code cleanliness and good structure is when they take over somebody else's code, right? It's like, taking over somebody else's code is like cleaning up somebody else's room, right? You move in there and you're like, oh, wait, where is it? You know, I don't know where everything is. I mean, I don't understand how any of this stuff works. And you can take ages trying to figure things out, and it's easy to badmouth the last person, but, you know, the job is the job, and you eventually have to get on with it, right? So it's not until you actually take over somebody else's code that you realize how important good code structure is, right? And the same thing with error handling, right? I can remember, you know, never doing any error handling, or I'll do, you know, try, catch, and then the catch was just empty, right? I was notorious for that, for like when I was first started out, right? And then, you know, when things break and you don't know what's going on, that's when you start to realize how important this kind of stuff is. So this is the thing with a lot of junior developers. So anyway, today I just wanted to say a little bit about that, because, you know, it's very easy, you know, when you've been in software for a long time, it's really easy to get on the one side, if you work with other developers, to spend so much time on just making sure the code is perfect, when it doesn't make any difference to the end user, right? But in the long run, it's more maintainable, and you can have, you know, and it's easier to get somebody else in to work on it, you know, all that kind of stuff. You know, and on the other side, it's just easy to go through and just code away. You know, it's working, you know, there's no problems, and then, you know, in the end, something falls over because, you know, if it's a huge success, you know, there's nobody to maintain it. You know, you're stuck with it because it takes too long to explain the code to somebody else. So anyway, I just thought I would take that little stance today in defense of spaghetti code, right? I don't have a problem with spaghetti code as long as I never, ever, ever have to work on it or own it, or it's never one of my apps. So anyway, so that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.